watching Game Show Network. You're watching Game Show Network.
You can win this sporty red Jeep on the turn of a single card on Card Sharks. And if you play your cards right, you can win $32,000. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks. Oh.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. If you've been watching our show, we have a delightful champion. And it seems for the last 3 days, we've started our show playing with the big money. And that's exactly what we're going to do today, because the lady's already won $12,975. She's a high school teacher from Pasadena, California. Here's Jackie Sapp.
Hi.
Hiya, Jackie. I introduced you like you were on Talent Scouts, you know?
Yeah.
How are you, Jackie?
I'm doing great today.
I want to know, tell the folks again about the last name of Sapp.
Well, I fell in love with a wonderful man, and unfortunately, his last name was Sapp, so I decided to take that name, and I've adjusted.
Did you try to convince him maybe to take your name?
Oh, did I? Or to combine, my maiden name was Whitaker, like Whitsapp or Sapolio. Can we make it Italian or something? You know?
But we're I don't think you would fly as an Italian, sweetheart.
Oh,
I
just want
you
to come.
Okay, this lady is such a good champion, and you've won over $12,000, and now we're going to give her a chance to win some more money and also a brand new car. Here's our two lovely dealers on Card Sharks, Susanna Williams and Lacey Pemberton. Good morning, girls.
How are you?
And as you know, they have a deck of cards over there that you cut earlier. I will remind you, as if you didn't know, that in addition to all of the money you can win, we've added some jokers to that deck. And every time a joker comes up, that gives you a chance of winning a new car. And our car today is a Jeep. It's that great red Jeep back there, and we'd love to see you win it. And because you are the champ, Lacey has one joker for you, so you know you at least have one opportunity of winning that car. We'd love to see you do it. So let's give her $200, and she's going to try to win the big one. Here we go. All right, Jackie, with $200, I've got a four.
Okay, I'm going to keep that and go $100 higher.
$100 higher than a four, it is.
Okay,
seven.
Great. I'm going to change that card, though, with number two.
Number two, okay. Seven will now be a jack.
Great.
You've got $300.
Okay. I'd like to bet $200 lower, Bob.
$200, lower than the jack. It is.
Great.
Seven again.
Okay.
$500,
okay,
you got to keep
it. Okay, I'm going to go with that seven. Let's go just $50 higher.
Atta girl, yeah. $50 higher than the seven. Look
all
at that.
Right.
$550 up here, another $400. That gives you $950.
That's great. That's great. All of it lower, Bob.
This is going to be worth $1,900 to you. Look at that.
Yeah.
You got it.
That's great. That's great. Okay, I'm going to go for it. All of it lower.
Going to go all of it, right?
All of it lower.
Yeah. $3,800. Player change.
I'm going to change that car with number one.
Number one. Let's see what it is. The six now is a king again.
Yeah.
$3,800, Jackie. Oh, sweet temptation.
$3,000 lower.
$3,000. Going to go $3,000 lower than the king. Yeah. $6,800.
Oh,
now, I want to change the eight.
Change it with number three, please.
Okay, let's see what the eight is. The eight is a five.
Oh, I love those
now,
fives.
Now, Jackie, you've got $6,800. You're the math teacher. You got to bet at least half, which is how much?
I can do that, Bob. $3,400.
How much you want to bet?
I'd like to bet the $3,400 that it's going to be higher.
$3,400 that it's higher than
money.
The five. Be there for Jackie.
That's
it's a
okay.
Push. No
That's
win,
okay.
No loss. $6,800.
All right,
those fives.
That's
they just
wonderful.
Chase you, don't
That's
they?
Wonderful.
Here we go, hon. Another $6,800. You're now in cash now, $19,775.
Oh, wow.
Okay? Thank you, Lacey.
Sure, good luck.
Great.
And Lacey has this joker for you.
Okay.
And we want you to win that Jeep back there, really.
Win this Jeep.
Because over there behind one of those cards is the word car. If you find it, this is the one you will win. Gino?
The Wrangler from Jeep Corporation offers both on and off road driving in comfort. The Wrangler comes with Sport Decor Group and California Emission. Good luck, Jackie.
All right, Jackie.
Okay.
Go find it, sweetheart.
This is
and
it.
You drive it.
It's right here.
Number one today. Gotta get it. Let's get it. Come on. Let's win a car. Is it behind number one? If the word car is behind number one, you'll be driving to school in that
That's
red Jeep.
All right
boy,
with
those
me,
students
Bob.
Will say, look at Mrs. Sapp. Is it behind number one?
Oh.
for three today.
Now it's three. Okay. All right. God. That's all right.
You still have enough money to buy it.
I think that. So.
$19,775. Back in just a moment. We need a new challenge. This is I want you to win that card.
Me too.
Password, Password Plus, Super Password Tattletales, Card Sharks, Card Sharks, The Buzzard, Daytime Tango starts weekdays at 2.
BuzzardPlay.com is now BuzzardTV.com. The same great content with a whole new address. BuzzardTV.com. Log on and let's play.
We are back. Oh, you're doing well. $19,775. And it's time to meet a new challenger for you. And he's a spiffy guy. I want you to meet George. And here he is.
Hi, George.
Hi, Bob.
George.
Hi.
Boy, you look wonderful today.
I sure do.
You look, I like the bow tie. It gives you that Paul Simon kind of a look. You know what I mean?
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Only I'm not running for senator this year.
He's not. He's running for president.
Well, he's still senator.
Oh, that's right. He is. Sorry. Thank you for correcting me. We're off to a real, real good start.
Right.
Tell me about George.
Well, my name is George Kaplan, and I'm 76 years young.
Yes.
And I'm married for the second time to my wonderful wife, Cece.
How long have you been married to Cece?
Oh, 8 wonderful years.
Is that right?
Yes, and I'm sorry I didn't meet her many, many years ago. But it's never too late to be happy, and I'm very, very happy.
I couldn't be happier for you. Congratulations to you, sir. Okay, George. You know how to play this game, I assume?
I sure do, Bob.
Well, then here we go, pal. Win 2 games and you're the champ. Jackie, first question belongs to you. Lacey Pemberton is our dealer today. She's dealt out the cards from decks you cut earlier, and we're on our way with question number 1. Jackie, here it is. We surveyed 100 married men, and we asked them, if your wife committed a crime and was sentenced to 5 years in prison, would you be willing to go to prison and serve the 5 years in her place? How many married men said they would go to prison for their wife?
Well, I know if I committed a crime and I had to go to prison, I believe my husband would wait for me to come out of prison, but I really don't believe he'd go in my place. In fact, he'd probably say, I could take care of so much, honey, out here.
Sure.
So he would probably, he wouldn't do that. And I believe that a lot of married men would feel the same way. Therefore, Bob, I believe that that number is going to be higher.
How many married men said they would go to prison for their wife?
Thank you. That number's lower. It's going to be 33 people.
33 married men said they would go to prison for their wife. Let's see what Mr. In Love would say about this one. George, what do you think? Wife committed a crime, sentenced to 5 years. Would you spend the 5 years in jail for her?
I think that if I was a young man...
I didn't ask you that, George.
If I have children...
I didn't ask you that either, George. Your wife just committed a crime, 5 years in jail. Would you go to jail for her?
I believe that being that she's been a faithful wife all these years...
Yes.
And taking care of me and my family.
Would you go to prison for her, George?
Yes, I would go to prison for her.
You're a fool,
Absolutely.
George.
Absolutely. I'm a fool, but I love my wife.
Okay. So you're saying higher or lower than 33 would go to jail for their wives?
I believe that it should be lower.
So you're going to say it's lower?
I believe so.
The actual number of married men who would go to prison for their wife is 41 of them. Was it lower or was it higher? I mean, I'll take her a box lunch every week and things like that and give her a new book, but crying out loud. Jackie, look here.
All right, Bob, I'm going to go lower.
Lower than the A's,
Okay, great. Higher
than the 3. Got it.
Yeah, lower, Bob.
Is it lower?
Okay.
Hey, George.
A break for George.
A break for George, yes. Before you go to jail, George, here's a queen for you.
Lower,
yeah.
Oh, higher.
Higher than the 7, no.
Ah.
Thank you, Lace. Okay, we'll pause for these words. We'll be right back with more Card Sharks right after this. Thank you, Susanna, very much. All right, let's continue now. George, the next question is yours. And George, all this week we've had 10 California taxicab drivers in our studio audience, and they are back with us again today. There they are, folks. One of them's dressed a little funny, but he's a cab driver. George, before the show, we ask our 10 cabbies, has anyone ever tried to pay their fare with something other than money? How many of these 10 cabbies said someone has tried to pay them with something other than money?
If I was a cab driver and I'm dealing in human nature, I think the temptation is very, very much in evidence. And how many would...
You got yourself in trouble. I'm going to see you bail yourself out, George.
Yeah. Bail me out.
How many of these 10 cabbies said someone has tried to pay them with something other than money?
My uneducated guess would be about 4.
4? Okay, let's see what Jackie says.
Okay, I believe that people get in a jam sometimes and they really want to do the right thing, but they just may not have the money. And I believe for that reason, the answer is definitely going to be higher.
Higher than that?
Mm-hmm.
The actual number of these cabbies who said someone has tried to pay their fare with something other than money is 10 of them. All.
Yeah. Definitely.
You devils, you. All right, Jim, tell us all the gory details. Was it, first of all?
This lady at the Long Beach Airport one night, Bob.
It was a lady then, right?
Excuse me?
A lady.
Yeah, a lady at the Long Beach Airport got off a flight from Alaska.
Yes.
And she had to go to Laguna Beach. All she had was a 10-pound salmon.
A 10-pound salmon?
Yeah. A couple other cabbies turned it down. You know, slow night. What the heck? You know, I love salmon. About a $35 trip, so I figured I came out ahead.
So you took
fresh
her...
salmon.
You took
salmon.
Her all the way to Long Beach for a salmon?
No, from Long Beach to Laguna.
From Long Beach to Laguna for a 10-pound salmon.
Yeah, it was delicious.
Another cabby fishy story. I understand. Thank you, fellas, very much. Nice to have you here. All right. Here we go, Jackie.
Okay, we're going to keep that card, Bob. We're going to go lower.
Lower. Got it.
Ooh. Okay, I'm going to go lower again.
Lower than the 10. 7.
Okay. Freeze. Yeah. I'm going to stop
there. She'll freeze right there. Keeps George off the cards, and we'll go on to our next question.
I'm going to go.
Wait a minute, George. You have no choice. She froze. You can go anywhere you want to, George, but I'm going to ask another question right here.
Let's go.
You thought you were going to get a free chance.
I thought I did.
Now she froze on you, George, to keep you away from the cards.
Okay.
She's that kind of a woman, George.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to watch her every minute.
Every minute.
Okay, here's another question. This is yours, Jackie. Surveyed 100 women who decided to have a child out of wedlock.
Mm.
We asked them, when you selected a father for your baby, which was more important to you, his looks or his brains? How many unmarried moms said they selected a father for his brains?
Oh, I really think that number is going to be a low number. I have girlfriends who are not married yet, and they're considering doing that. And everybody wants a cute little baby. And most people think that you can train a child to be intelligent. Therefore, the brains are not that important at conception. That's what a lot of people think. Therefore, the women who chose a man because of his brains is going to be... 21.
Really? 21? How
Absolutely.
Interesting.
Absolutely. Looks is the thing for kids.
Yeah. All babies are cute.
Not all of them, Bob. Mine is.
George, she says 21 out of 100 unmarried moms said they selected a father for his brains. Will it be higher or lower than that?
Well, I am inclined to agree with her thinking. The people that I know primarily try to select for their brains. And you said 25 would
be... You know a lot of unmarried moms, George?
Oh, sure.
She said 21. Higher or lower than that?
In my opinion, I think it would be higher.
Higher, you say?
Absolutely.
The actual number of single moms who selected a father for his brains is 36. You're right, George. It was higher. Not very much higher, but it was. All right, George, you want to keep the queen?
I'm going to keep that card and go lower.
Is it lower? Yeah.
I want to keep that card and go lower.
Lower again. Certainly is.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher than the 5. Got it again.
I want to go lower.
If it's lower, you win $100.
Lower,
you win the game.
Lower.
Yeah.
Hey. Thank you.
George, you've got me yelling, too. You know that.
Uh-huh.
I got all excited for you.
Well,
I have
a lot of exuberance.
I noticed that. And a bow tie, too. You have $100.
Absolutely.
You won the first game. Win the next game, and you'll be our champion.
Wow.
We will be right back to start game number 2 after this. Don't go away. Welcome back to Card Sharks. And now let us continue with our two delightful players. And we're setting up now for game number 2. Jackie, you have to win this game to stay in. George, if you win this game, you're the new champ. So we are on our way with an educated guess question. George, you'll like this one. George, in 1912, when the Titanic sailed on her maiden voyage, what was the cost of the most expensive luxury suite? Now, you have an advantage in this question because you were around in 1912, weren't you?
Hey, no.
What year were you born, George?
1910. You got your arithmetic a little bit wrong.
I should have checked with my math teacher right there.
Don't make me older than I am.
I certainly won't.
I don't want to resemble that remark.
No, How much did it, the most expensive luxury suite cost in 1910? 12.
From what I understand, the Titanic was the most luxurious ship in those days. Absolutely. And I would say that the luxury suite was kind of expensive. I would say...
Say it, George.
80.
80 what?
Out of 100. Now, wait a minute. You want the price? Wait a minute. You want the price. Okay, you want the price. $1,000.
$1,000.
Okay.
What are you chewing on, George?
Sugarless candy.
I see. I heard something clicking in his mouth. I thought his teeth were loose.
No.
Scared me to death.
Uh-uh.
Oh, they're okay. Fine.
Keep my weight down.
Yeah, I got you. He said the actual cost of the most expensive luxury suite on the Titanic was $1,000. Jackie, do you think it'd be higher or lower than that?
I agree with George. $1,000 is a lot of money back in 1912, but when Titanic said luxury, they meant luxury, and that number's going to be higher.
It'll be higher?
Yes. Well,
let me tell you, the cost of the most expensive luxury suite on the Titanic was $4,350.
Wow.
Whoa! Was it ever higher? Okay,
money.
Jackie. Here we go.
Okay, change that card, Bob.
Yeah, we will. Lacey's got a new one for you. Guess what it is.
Okay, my favorite card. Higher.
Higher than the 5. Six.
All right. We're going to climb up a little bit more higher.
Higher than the 6. 3.
Oh, okay.
George with a free shot. My friend, look here. That's yours. Can't change it.
Boy, that's a tough card.
I know.
I'll go higher.
Well, let's see if it is higher. Yeah.
Lower
than the
lower.
10, the man says it certainly
I'll
is.
I'll go higher.
Higher than the 3. How about an ace?
I'll go lower.
If it's lower, you're the new champ. You are!
Thank you. You want a lot of money.
Way to go,
way to go.
Jackie. You're not only intelligent, you're very pretty, and you're a delightful contestant. You walk away with $19,775.
Right.
Say hi to everybody passing the high school. Give them my regards.
Thanks,
son. Nice having you here. Come on, George.
Thank you, Bob.
Get right over here, my friend. Let me fix your tie. There we go. I got you all fixed.
Watch you on your show.
Oh, thank you. You've been watching me since you were young, I know.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. Hey, let me tell you. Now, the $200 you've won is yours to keep no matter what happens. But now some really nice things are about to happen to you. The ladies are going to deal out some cards that you cut earlier. Uh-huh. I will tell you that in addition to all of the money, and there's a lot of money you can win over there, we've added some jokers to that deck.
Right.
And if a joker comes up, that means it gives you another chance of winning that new Jeep. And boy, would you look spiffy.
Oh, yes.
Would you look spiffy running around in that Jeep.
I like red no matter what color it is.
I got you. And because you're the champ, Lacey has one joker for you, so you know you at least have one opportunity of winning that car, okay? You can change one card per line. Keep that in mind. These are important rules.
I'll keep that in mind,
Bob. We want you to win. You ready?
Thanks a lot.
Give him $200.
Ready.
You want me to leave, don't
ready.
You? All right, George. First card happens to be a deuce.
All of it higher.
All of it higher than the deuce queen. $400, George.
All of it lower.
All of it, he says. All of it lower. Yeah. 800. Player change, George.
Change that to number 2.
Number two. Man knows how to play this game. Sure. 9 is now a 3.
All of 800.
All of it?
All the way.
All of it higher. It is. 1,600 up here. Give you another 400. You got $2,000. You can play or change the 10.
Change that to number 1.
Number 1, he says. Let's see what the 10 now is. The 10's now a king. Oh. 2,000, George.
The whole works lower.
All of it?
Go ahead. Lower.
Whoa. Man steps up to the bar, doesn't he? Is it lower? Yeah. $4,000, George. You got to play it. You can't change it.
I cannot change it.
No, you've already changed on this line.
$50 lower.
$50 lower. That's the way to play it. 50 lower than the 10. 10, push. Okay, here we go.
50 lower.
50 lower again. Is it lower? Boy, is it ever. Now, $4,050. Got to bet at least half of it. What are you going to do, pal?
The whole works higher.
Atta boy, step up to it. He's going to bet it all. All of it higher. Yeah!
Thank you, Bob.
$8,100.
Thank you.
$8,300 in cash. We're going to give you a chance to win that spiffy Jeep in just a moment. We'll be right back with that. All the time we have for today. We couldn't be happier for you, really.
Thank you.
And what we're going to do, when we start our show next time, we're going to start it off with you trying to win that new car, okay? So I know you'll be back. We certainly hope you'll be back. For Lacey Pemberton, Susanna Williams, Gene Wood, and the whole gang, I'm Bob Eubank saying thank you very much. We had a great time today. Hope you did, too. Bye-bye, everybody. See you.
Some of our departing contestants will receive Light and Thirsty, the mop with unique cloth strips that are super absorbent and super tough. Light and Thirsty by O'Cedar. Depart from ordinary meals with new La Choy Chicken Sweet and Sour and Chicken Teriyaki Dinners. La Choy, a welcome departure. Theragran M multivitamins with B-complex and biotin that turn food into energy. Theragran M from Squibb with energy releasers. Contact, nighttime cold medicine, effective relief with a taste preferred 2-to-1 over the leading nighttime liquid cold formula. If you like a burger with the works, you'll love Manwich. It's the burger with the works inside. When you feel a cold coming on, take Coracidin. It helps relieve cold symptoms. Coracidin at the first sign of a cold. And the member of our studio audience will receive Emerson's 10-inch color TV with electronic tuning, available in red or white. Fully designed to be a fashion accessory in any setting. Another fine product from Emerson. This is Gene Wood speaking for Cut Shark, a Mark Goodson television production.
General knowledge skills as contestants compete to win loads of cash and a new automobile.
And what was the film?
Ingrid Bergman, Casablanca?
Yes.
Robert.
Catherine Hepburn, The African Queen?
Yes. Shelley?
Mary Astor, The Maltese Falcon?
You people know your movies.
Behind there, it says car! It says car the first time out of the barrel.
Don't miss the action on TV's hottest new game show, Split Second, starring Monty Hall.
Split Second, weeknights at 7:30 on TV 11.
Nickelodeon presents Great Moments in Chaos. April 15th, 1897, the first ever transcontinental train race ends in a tie. March 4th, 1911, laboratory experiments reveal that if man were meant to fly, he would use devices that look more like planes. On November 2nd, 1987, Nickelodeon unveiled the next Great Moment in Chaos, a new game show called Finders Keepers. Be there every weekday at precisely 6 o'clock, 5 o'clock Central, for history in the making. Finders Keepers on Nickelodeon.
This is a test of the Jeopardy broadcast system. This station is conducting a test of your skill at Jeopardy. This is only a test.
The category, landmarks. It's the world's largest office building, named for its shape. Good luck.
This was only a test, but if you said, what is the Pentagon, you're ready for an actual Jeopardy game and are advised to tune to this station.
Channel 9, your station for Jeopardy.
Now back to regular programming.
Challenge Lady Luck and win up to $32,000.
Lower than a queen. It is lower than a queen. It's Kelly Wynn. A king. A deuce. No.
Card Sharks with host Bill Rafferty. Today at 4:30 on Channel 13.
Well, tomorrow on Buzznumber.
Stage and television star of To Tell the Truth, lovely Kitty Carlisle.
Thank you. And this is my partner, Tom Gaughan, from West Springfield, Massachusetts.
This is the star of the forthcoming film, The Horizontal Lieutenant, versatile Jack Carter.
Hello, and this is my partner, Norma Botterman, from Mitchell, South Dakota. And we're all here to play Password.
Good Yes, it's Password. Brought to you this evening by the Polaroid 10-second automatic camera. Only three buttons to push. One, two, three. And in just 10 seconds, a finished picture. And now, here's your host on Password, Alan Ludden.
Well, that was fun. We're enjoying a wonderful lineup of Buzz Denver. We're enjoying a wonderful lineup.
Good evening. Very nice to have you with us to play Password tonight. Versatile Jack Carter, it's good to see you.
You still look like a tall George Goble to me.
Thanks a lot.
Shorten up and get out of the business.
Nice to have you. Kitty, it's Hello. Very good to have you back.
Thank you.
Say, tell me, when was the first time you ever played Password?
I played Password in order to demonstrate the whole game for CBS in the office at Goodson Todman's, and I feel very responsible because we sold the show that day.
You certainly did, and you started the whole thing with me.
That's right.
And I appreciate it. It's good to have you back.
Oh, thank you.
Let's talk to this gentleman here, and you're right, Tom Gaughan by name. Let's see, Tom, what do you do for a living?
I'm in the Navy, and I've been in the Navy for 3 years. I'm a lieutenant junior grade.
Lieutenant junior grade. You familiar with the Navy, Kitty?
Where are you stationed?
Right now, I'm underway for Camp Lejeune in North Carolina.
Oh, you're not coming out our way to California?
More or less, someday. No doubt, they all do. All right, good luck to you playing Password today, Jack Carter.
Yes, boy. You're going to stand there like Maximilian Schnell? What is this? Look like Judgment at CBS.
Tell me, what about this movie of yours? What about this?
You're going to pick on that again?
Yeah, tell me about it.
It's Horizontal Lieutenant. The reason for the title is I'm very lazy in the picture. I'm an officer. I'm a lieutenant, sir. I've got my own Lejeune. But in the big battle scene where the Japanese are attacking, I grab a rifle and I tear through the underbrush and I'm fighting and
when does it open?
And single-handed.
When does it open?
I break
when
into
does
the
it
nurse's quarters.
When does it open?
Let me finish the joke. At your neighborhood theater in about a week.
All right. Very good. Meet the lady on your right, left here, Norma Botterman. Are you married, Norma?
Yes, I am. And I have two children, Jane and John. And my husband is a captain in the Army.
I'll see you around.
Army. Oh, he's a captain. Good luck to you playing Password. And we'll get around to playing Password in just a moment. All right, now let's play Password. Are you ready?
Tune in for Buzzvember tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific on my YouTube channel. Have a good day.